Okay, let me start reading you the title. As you can see, it is on accessibility for Linux and the lay system. Let me start explaining to you what I mean with the word accessibility. Accessibility is a property that is nothing more than a relative for the well-known property of controllability. If we start considering a system in this very general form, we are able now to define these two sets. The first one is describing all the sets, all the states that I can reach after definitely a time t. While the second one is representing the set of all the reachable states that one can reach after a time equal or greater than zero. So these two sets are useful to define formally what I mean with accessibility. So a system sigma is seen to be accessible from a state x if the interior of the set that we have defined before is a non-empty set. So if we look at, for example, the last statement, we see that the system is globally controllable from a state if the set of all reachable states first is equal to the main goal on which my system can refer. Graphical explanation one of the formal definition that I gave you before. So we see in this case that a line, for example, on a plane is not accessible since obviously it cannot have a non-empty interior. For the accessibility, I see in this case that I can move not in any direction, but I can move. And the last one is okay. This example will clarify the difference that there exists between these two properties. If you consider this system and our medical in this case is R2, with the gray part on the plane, we are describing the set or states, and I can see that the origin, for example, is a point that is accessible but not controllable because I'm in this case. Okay. Okay. Time delay systems are full of surprises. Now, some of them. If I look at this very simple example, that it is even linear, a question comes out naturally, and then it is, where can I go? The answer, if we compute the controllability matrix, is rather trivial. Obviously, I can move on subspaces characterized by this equation, but if now I make a delay appear, in the second equation, the answer given is real, but maybe it is longer. I have to answer, I have to integrate first over the interval, that is here a mistake, over the interval 0 and epsilon, and then over epsilon 2 epsilon, considering a piecewise constant function for our control, so it will be equal to u0 in the first over the first interval and u1 over the second one. So I can get the solution and replacing the solution that I get for the second integration, I can now consider the final. State that is an arbitrary final state. So I'm able to find action on the refinery constant delay has improved the great acceptance, okay, of the accessibility of power system. Okay, now we have to go in depth with about our delayed systems. If we consider this very simple example, we can ask, okay, but what is happening before zero? To answer, I need something more than the standard, the classical initial condition that is both a constant. In this case, I have to specify point by point what is happening. So I need a function, this function, this my initial function, to specify the trend of the state variables before zero, and it's due to underline that in this case, this function can even not satisfy the dynamics of the system. Okay, I'll focus on a subclass of delayed systems, namely those affected by constant commensurate delays. With commensurate, we mean that every delay that appears in my system can be represented as a multiple of the smallest one. We can now use this kind of system in this form, studying not only the dynamics time t, but even the dynamics at time t less 1, t less 2, until t less s sum. Okay, what we are getting is something that we call the extended system, which has s additional delays on the state variables with replacement, we get easily that the system now is describing, let's say, a broader class of systems, and we can see this one as a cascade of a system. The first one described by the first equation, and the second one. Intuitive structure. If we focus on the case when I have just one delay, the block representation is this one. Okay, so we leave the classical representation to make a new one. The differential representation, that is intended to simply apply the differential operator side by side. So in this case, and I'm getting this form, and I am even to introduce the delay operator delta. The delay operator delta simplify in a certain sense the representation, because in this case, for example, I don't have the x of t less 1, but in this case I have the x multiplied by the operator delta. This quantity is nothing more than a binary matrix, and please pay attention to this quantity, which is a polynomial vector that is very useful for the tools that I'm going to introduce now. So this is a general form of polynomial vector that in particular case it may be equal to G1. So a definition is given of a generalized linear So, from the generalized networking, it's rather obvious moving from moving to the generalized Lee bracket. In this case, what I'm doing is making this operation, so the Lee bracket between two columns of this matrix that is describing row by row, if you want, the dynamics of the dynamics of the extended system. So in the first row I will have the components with respect to x zero. It would be humanity. And I'm assuming that the Commodore has voice in this case, changing over two steps to one quality and computing the flow, and then computing the second order derivative calculating zero. So at this point, I can system, then only on XRT, then the system is not accessible. So the proof is rather trivial, since there exists the J function depending only on XRT. I can consider the this change of coordinates where I use for the first J equation the autonomous function that I have found, and I complete the transformation with n minus j other function, and what I get is that the first set of variables are not affected by a control, while the second one are affected by the control variable. So the system is not accessible. So to arrive to the last result of my contribution, you can consider this algorithm that it's like an upgrade of the previous result, because if I have function that depend on x of t only and other that depend over even on x of t minus e, it is not sure that I can find the leafy change of coordinates as I did before. So I can use that algorithm, and I can arrive to this statement that is giving us a necessary condition for the accessibility and a sufficient condition for accessibility. So suppose that the system is not accessible, and we have J function, this J autonomous function, such that, okay, then the system is not accessible if the algorithm that described you before apply to this first set and provide a non-empty integral for this solution. So the proof is intuitive, because it follows what I have done before. Some conclusion and future developments can be studied, for example, necessary and sufficient condition to confer accessibility, or even why not understand how the introduction of a delay can improve the grade of accessibility, and if yes, how many delay we have to introduce to increase the performance of this type of performance. Okay, thanks.
In the linear case, what do you mean by accessibility? There is a more simpler or more intuitive definition or interpretation?
We have studied accessibility for nonlinear time delay system. In literature, for the linear case, the delay linear case, we have two different concepts. And accessibility is a quicker condition than these two properties that are weak and strong controller.